To Joseph P. Kennedy, head of the new Maritime Commission, the President has assigned the gigantic task of rejuvenating America's moribund merchant marine. No man ever had a more staggering job, but Mr. Kennedy is full of confidence.
There is no doubt that the American people need an adequate merchant marine. Nor is there any doubt that the American people are going to have an adequate merchant marine. Most of our ships are so old that assuming 20 years as the economic life of a ship, within 5 years, 85% of our tonnage will be antiquated. For us, an adequate merchant marine means a new merchant marine. The government, with the assistance of the shipping industry, must begin a program which will equip our overseas trade so that it may be second to none in first-class equipment. We are going to lay the keels for new fast ships, and we're going to do it now.
Here's a graphic commentary on our merchant marine situation. Useless ships built during the World War and still hanging around, nobody knows what for. Meanwhile, foreign vessels for the most part crowd the New York piers. Every day sees some huge liner sailing with plenty of Americans and their dollars on board. But from mighty few of them do the stars and stripes float. At the very time Mr. Kennedy made his statement, a News of the Day cameraman flew over the once great Leviathan, rusting at her dock, outdated and outmoded. In painful contrast, the Queen Mary, Britain's floating palace, was speeding a few miles away, Europe-bound. No American can look at this picture without wondering what's the matter with Uncle Sam. But he's about to wake up.